Coach, Irish OFL with warchant.com. Playing against at Louisville and Kansas, what did that do? Do you think that experience, especially the success that a couple of your guys really had in those games, what does that do going into a game like this?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's going to help us out tremendously. You know, we put together a really challenging non-conference schedule that included at Louisville and at Kansas. So hopefully that will pay benefits tomorrow. You know, I think this will be the most athletic and longest team we play all year. So I think it will be an adjustment getting used to their size and athleticism. But hopefully once the game starts and we can get a feel for that, we'll settle in.
If you have a question for Coach Becker, please raise your hand. We'll send one of the microphone attendants in your direction. Questions for Coach? Up front on the left side.
Neil Ostrow with the Journal Inquirer. Coach, you've obviously been back here plenty of times, at least in the area, but when's the last time you played in this building or coached in this building? Is it just nice to be back and see some friendly faces?
Yeah, no, it's really exciting for me and my family to have this opportunity. And last time I was in this building, I think it was when I took my daughter to see the Eagles here a couple years ago. But the last time for a basketball game was their national championship year with Kemba Walker and those guys. And it was pretty neat. Ryan Russillo gave our pregame talk in our locker room, and Mike Lonergan was the head coach. I was an assistant, and we were up 3, I think, at the half, and then things changed in the second half, unfortunately. But they went on to win the national championship. Napier was a freshman, and Kemba was a pretty good backcourt they had there. And so, it will be really, really neat tomorrow to be able to coach out here as a head coach in an NCAA tournament game in my home state.
Continuing with questions for Coach Becker, let's go back to the right. Ira.
Coach, when you look at Florida State and you put together your game plan, is it 3 things, 5 things, or what do you focus on going into a game against them?
Yeah, I mean, it's a pretty simple game plan, and offensively, you know, we're going to have to probably make a lot of shots, shoot a lot of threes just because of their size in and around the basket. And then defensively, I think rebounding is going to be really important. We're a good defensive team. We're a really good defensive rebounding team, but we haven't played the likes of this size before. And so we're going to have to really clean up the glass and box out and get rebounds. If we can do that, we can get out and play in transition and hopefully attack them early before they can get their defense set. So, there's a lot of similarities to our recent games as far as the game plan goes. And we'll see.
Coach, next question's in the back of the room, just to the left of center.
Hey, John. Mike Abelson, New Hampshire Union leader. Two quick ones for you. First one, what can you say about Anthony's maturation this season and how much will the team rely on him tomorrow? And how can the team continue to stay as dialed in as they were in the conference tournament?
Yeah, Anthony's been amazing this year. His growth as a player, he's really, his perimeter skills have really improved in 3-point shot and really made him a hard cover. But most importantly, as a leader, he's been tremendous. And he's become, along with Ernie Duncan, become the leader of this team. And he's been there every day for us and every night. You know, he shoots 35% of our shots, which is very different than how most Vermont teams play, where it's much more balanced scoring. We've really relied on Anthony night in and night out, and he's delivered. And the other piece of him offensively is really become a complete player and really is passing the ball when he's doubled and triple teamed and was an all defensive player this year, which is which I'm really proud of. He's become a really good two-way player. He's going to be important for us, obviously, again tomorrow. So, and what was the second part of your question?
How can you keep your team's focus as they were in the conference?
Yeah, I mean,
tournament?
We've been really, really focused, and for a young team, that's been, been really important for us. And we've gotten better as the year has gone on. And I thought in our conference tournament was the best we've done all year of executing our system and executing the game plan. And, you know, for a full 40 minutes, our guys did a really good job with that. And, you know, there'll be excitement early in the game around being in an NCAA tournament, but hopefully we can, you know, calm down early in the game and settle in, get a feel for their athleticism and go out there and play to win.
In the back of the room on the right side, Coach, Ralph.
Ralph Russo from the Associated Press. John, I'm wondering your experience coaching at Gallaudet. How that shaped your career, unique experience, does it make you become a different kind of coach in some ways?
Yeah, I mean, I learned a lot from that experience as a young coach. And the first and probably most important is just the value of communication, you know, and where I had to teach myself sign language to communicate with my players and other coaches. And I took that really seriously and you know, really proud that, you know, was able to communicate there. And you know, we take for granted, you know, the communication piece. I had never have since then. We over communicate in our program here and understand the importance of that and the value of that and how easy it is for us. And that, you know, and the friendships I made there and just to be part of that culture and part of that community gave me a great appreciation for a lot of things that I have and that we have. You know, I stay hopefully a little bit part of that community I bring forward with me. And it's made me a better coach for sure.
We have time for a few more questions for Coach Becker, if there are any. Let's go back up to the front on the right. Ira.
Ira Schoenfeld, warchant.com. What UMBC did last year, does that do anything? Is that relevant at all for the conference? I know this isn't a 1-16 matchup.
But. Yeah. No, I think, you know, we're really proud of what UMBC, as a conference member, we're really proud of what UMBC was able to accomplish last year. You know, and so I think as a conference, we have confidence and we want to be competitive and we want to win games in the tournament. We can see what that does for us and they help give us confidence. We've won some NCAA tournament games, obviously a Syracuse game and Lamar in the first four in 2012. And so as a conference, we really pride ourselves on being a little underappreciated and undervalued. And so this is our opportunity to show the country just how good of a conference we are. And you know, we're here representing our conference, and we expect to advance.
On the right side,
John, can you talk a little bit about the preparation to play Florida State with your reserves? Because they're not quite the same length and the same athleticism. How did you prepare, and how did those guys prepare for their role in getting your starters ready?
Yeah, and I think our bench is going to have to play well tomorrow. I mean, just with how hard Florida State plays, and they play 11 guys, and you know, to play the full 40 minutes, we're going to have to trust the bench. They're going to have to be productive. We're going to have to keep rotating guys so that we can play, you know, the whole game, so to speak. And so, you know, our bench has been inconsistent all year. Has been much better. I've tinkered with the starting lineup more than I ever had this year, as recently as the conference playoffs. And so our bench is constantly kind of evolving. And I like where our starters and who we have coming off the bench and how they complement each other. And so we'll need them to play well.